Before I begin, I'd just like to know, how many of you recognize the quadratic formula? Please raise your hands if you do. All right, that's quite a few of you. To those of you who don't, trust me, ignorance is bliss. Enjoy it while it lasts. Now, how many of you think you could explain how this formula works? Please raise your hands if you do. There's a little less of you now. Maybe when you first learned about this formula, you wondered how it was derived, how people discovered it. Or maybe you couldn't care less and just wanted to get out of math class. To be honest, that was me. Either way, many of us still apply this formula today when solving quadratic equations without knowing the reasoning behind it. This is very similar to what's happening with AI tools, in particular, chatbots, where researching a topic has become so easy that we can afford to blindly apply the knowledge gained through the use of these AI tools. This completely undermines their potential and how much they could actually help us if we took the time to learn how to use these tools effectively. My name is Sarah, and I would like to talk about why and how we should use AI. AI is all around us, and it has been for a while. From the algorithms that fuel your Instagram feed to the Google search bar, AI has always been a useful tool for humanity. So why has it gained so much attention in the recent months? AI has always been developing, so what's the big difference now? Sam Altman, the CEO of OpenAI, which is the company responsible for AI tools such as ChatGPT, DALL-E, and Codex, stated in a podcast that ease of use matters a lot, even if the base capability was there before. In other words, AI tools have always been around, but they have never been as easy to use as clicking a link and typing a query into a text box. For example, the dialogue format between the user and the chatbot in ChatGPT makes it feel like the AI is truly trying to help you achieve your goals. Even the term chatbot has been coined to make it feel like a friendly assistant, even though all it actually is are strings of text printed across your screen. Did you know that the first chatbot to ever exist, named Eliza, was created in 1966? That's over 50 years ago. And while its capabilities were far behind the chatbots of this era, it still sparked the same feelings of awe and even worry we have towards AI today. Now, this fear and worry arises from the uncertainty we have towards this new technology. As stated before, AI tools have never been as easy to use as they are now. The problem with this ease of use is that we start to see AI tools as a shortcut, using them to get to the answers without understanding how we got there. At the time my chatbots could easily fill in the role of a tutor, this completely undermines their potential. Learning has become so much easier. What would be hours of scrolling through scientific journals and reading countless articles can now be condensed into a 5-minute read. So why are we using chatbots to avoid learning rather than using them to learn more efficiently? Of course, even I myself am tempted by this. If I copy and pasted entire paragraphs from AI chatbots, I could easily finish tasks in a fraction of the time it would take me otherwise. But ultimately, I wouldn't understand a word I've written, not to mention commit an act of academic dishonesty. Instead of trying to cut corners, it would be much more beneficial if I asked the AI to explain topics I couldn't yet understand and then formulate my own answer. This would still be much faster than manually searching through Google for information, but will also allow me to gain a deeper understanding of the topic at hand. Now, what steps do we need to take in order to ensure we are using AI to its full potential? The first thing would be to choose the right software. With every passing day, there are newer, smarter, faster chatbots out there on the internet, and they all have their own abilities and specialties. Some also require additional subscriptions or have a waitlist, such as Google Bard. On one hand, ChatGPT is great at pumping out detailed yet easy to understand explanations and summarizing long paragraphs. On the other hand, Microsoft Bing, which actually runs on the new GPT-4 model, has a precise mode for answering more fact-based questions and even cites its sources, allowing you to do deeper research. Hence, it would make sense to choose different softwares based on whether you are trying to improve your own work, learn about a new topic, or do deeper research into a topic you are already familiar with. Now, the next step is to use the right prompts. There are countless articles and YouTube videos out there on the internet detailing how you should prompt an AI for different tasks, and it would take hours to list them all here. However, one of the most important takeaways, especially when using AI for academic purposes and research, is to avoid asking broad questions, like, why does lightning occur? Instead, break down the topic and ask, what is lightning? What causes lightning? What are the conditions required for lightning to occur? Even better yet, if your teacher or textbook has given you a few key words to remember, ask the AI to explain the topic using those key words. The final and most important step is to be ready to read its response. This is where no amount of tech guides or YouTube videos can help you. Even though it may seem tedious to read through the 500 words printed on your screen, remember that it would probably take much longer to search for and filter through the same information manually. Besides, you could always ask the chatbot to summarize its response. A chatbot needs to be treated like a teacher rather than a textbook. After reading its response to your prompt, you could ask it to explain sections you don't yet understand or do more research into parts you find interesting. Take advantage of the fact that a chatbot can never get tired of your questions and can easily customize its response according to your requirements. If we as humans continue to take these steps and learn from rather than just copy off AI, we will be able to make unimaginable amounts of progress. This goes far beyond the realm of academics and research. The development of technology generally follows an exponential curve. Initially, progress is slow, when the technology has just been discovered and is still in development. Then, once people start to recognize its potential and usefulness, more competitors enter the market and rapid improvements are made. One of the most obvious examples of this is the development of mobile phones. From large bulky bricks that could only make phone calls to thin slabs that can capture memories, send text messages, and access the internet. All in just under 30 years. Right now, the development of chatbots has just begun. With Google, Microsoft, and other major tech brands entering the race, it is likely that we'll soon see the rapid development of chatbots as well. If we as humans continue to see chatbots as just another shortcut, blindly trusting their responses without fact-checking or doing deeper research, we might just as well be moving one step closer to an AI apocalypse. If we as humans continue to stay aware of these flaws and be aware that they can't be blindly trusted and followed, we will be able to ride this new wave of tech without being swept away by it. One of the first few things you see on ChatGPT's page is that it may occasionally generate incorrect information. All in all, as long as we stay aware of these flaws and use AI to learn more efficiently rather than to take shortcuts, we will be able to use AI in ways we can't even imagine yet. Thank you.